Hello, I'd like to welcome you to the first video of 99 Days, 99 Channels, recorded on August 11th, 2008. And the topic for the first channeling will be higher mind, lower mind, and no mind, the layers of the mind. Layers of the self. What a glorious topic to begin our eternal discussions on the nature of being, the nature of who we are, the nature of what we wish to express here in this material dimension of form, this dimension of apparent limitations, of causality and duality, all shadows cast over the true light of the self, the true light of who we are. Now, how do we all connect more with who we are? More of who we are bringing into our consciousness, into our life experience here and now as we walk forward into our daily lives. For we are all normal people, normal folks, not meditating on mountaintops, not hidden away in monasteries, in long-off villages in forgotten lands, doing secret meditations, obscure mantras, and various tactics to bring us closer to enlightenment, closer to who we are. For the truth of the matter is, we are who we are and we will never change. Our very being, our very essence, the core of ourself is always with us. It is always who we are. Never can we be different. Never can we change or obscure that which we really are. The light of God shines through us, never being touched by our outward experiences, never being touched by the thoughts and the manifestations that we bring into our life's experiences. For we are divine enlightened beings, for we are made of the light of God itself. We are that light pulsing itself into an experience that we ourselves are creating within our very awareness, within the awareness of God, within ourselves as images and holograms of the divine essence itself. For we are one and the same as God, one and the same as the true being that is pulsing itself into existence here and now. For how can you doubt this? How can you doubt that you are one and the same as God the Creator itself? For you are creating the experiences of your life, and you have been creating the experiences of your life from the very beginning. So how can they be any different from the creative powers that God Almighty has lying beside Himself, within His very core, expressing itself here and now, in this very room, in your very lives, each and every day? For you are creative beings expressing themselves and pulsing themselves into existence, into the fabric of life, weaving your life story into all that is, into the aspects of creation. For there are layers to your being, layers of your divine self that exist in various realms of form, various realms of experience, many dimensions of reality, existing within one and the same creator, one and the same creation of life, just different appearances, seemingly hidden from each other, veils over reality. And this is what we will touch upon today, the veils of your mind, the veils of your illusion that are keeping you separate, that are keeping you separate from the eternity that you are. For these veils of separation must fall away, and they will fall away in due time. Have faith and trust that as you step forward on your path of unfoldment into who and what you really are, that these layers of separation, that these ideas of false self will fall away, will be purified in the very light that you are. For there is no need to bring in external forms of purification into your life, for the very light of your being, the light of your soul, will purify all disturbances, all disruptions, and all fractures of self. For you yourself are whole and complete in the divine light of who you are, in the light of your very being, your very core. So trust that, know that, and allow it to come through more and more into your life. The layers of self, the layers of mind that we will touch upon today, are multifarious in their nature, many layers of reality expressing themselves in this realm, in this dimension that you call the mind. For it is a field of consciousness, it is a field of energy that exists within you and exists around you in your luminous orb, this luminous egg, this light body that you call your higher self. For you are a divine light, a light of source, a light of God, pulsing itself into an experience that itself is creating. And this lower mind, this talking mind, this incessant talking mind that never ceases with ideas and extrapolations, with thoughts and judgments, this talking mind is part of you, existing within you, yet it is not all of you. It is not the totality of you, and it can never touch upon who you really are. For this lower mind will be purified in its own time as you trust and surrender into that being, that pure light that is within you, that is within your heart, that is within your soul, this divine essence of who you are. The thoughts and experiences that exist in your lower mind are not of importance, so please stop focusing on them. Stop giving them the power that they do not deserve. Instead, place your attention, place your focus, and place your power on that which you really are, on the search for the divine self, allowing that which you truly are to be expressed more and more into your life, more and more into the here and now moment, so that you may recognize it, so that you may learn to love it and cherish it, and place it at its proper place in your life, at the utmost highest place, honoring who you are as a divine manifestation, a divine expression of the life and love energy of God itself pulsing through you into this material creation. The lower mind may have thoughts of objections to how things are going, may have thoughts of splendor and grandeur of what it wishes to create, yet these may not be in alignment with the soul's path, so cast them aside. Instead, rest in the eternal nature that you are, for this is what you really seek. The lower mind will choose objects that exist outside of you, that exist outside of your divine light, and weigh them as being important. Give your importance to them, give your power away to them, so that you will chase after them, seeking to bring them into your manifestation. And alas, you have achieved it. What great splendor you experience, but it is all temporary, and it will all fall away in due time, for it is not the true light of yourself. It is not the permanence of who you are as a permanent spiritual being living in the mind of God, being created by God, with God, for God, and being created of God. For you are a spark, you are a seedling of the divine consciousness, a holographic representation of all that is, of the splendor that is the Almighty God consciousness within yourself is the same as the Almighty God consciousness within all things, all beings, all creations, everything you perceive around you. For this is the understanding and this is the awareness that exists within the higher mind of who you really are, that supreme intelligence, that supreme source that will be channeled through you more and more each and every day as you open up to your divinity, as you open up to your divine nature. For that intelligence will not come from outside. You have not been taught that which resides within the higher mind. Instead, that intelligence will pulse through you, will pulse through your very being into an experience here. Learning to walk in harmony with this divine intelligence should be an utmost desire for you, for it will create bountiful splendor in your life, life that will then enlighten your heart, will lift you up into greater and greater realms of happiness, peace, bliss, compassion, and oneness with all of life around you, for that is what the higher mind experiences. While the lower mind experiences periods of separation and suffering, wishing things to be different, for that is always the attitude of the lower mind, a wishing and a wanting, a craving, a disease, an uneasiness based upon ideas of separation, wishing it to be different, wanting it to be different. For the lower mind itself is incomplete and must be purified. It must be brought into the light of the higher self. It must be reunited with the lost parts of the self that exist in higher spiritual planes, yet all the while are you, existing within you as you, who you really are. For you see, there is no separation between the higher mind and between the lower mind and between the self. For it is all one and the same creation of God, one and the same being, pulsing itself through existence, through reality, and into you, into your very life. For you are all these things, and you are so much more. So we ask that you wake up to the bountiful nature of your true being. We ask that you surrender into the divinity that you really are. We ask that you give up your ideas of persecution, persecution of self, persecution of others, persecution of life in general for perceived wrongdoings,